everybody, it is Paint Pouring Sandy, and today's pour is going to be my first strainer or colander pour. I'm very, very excited about this, and I've picked some really awesome bright colors that are going to go in our piece tonight. So first is just bright white here, Apple Barrel Bright Magenta. Anita's Acrylic Autumn Orange, Apple Barrel Bright Yellow, Apple Barrel Parakeet, Apple Barrel Turquoise. This one says gloss, but gloss does not matter. And Folk Art Neon. Neon Purple. So I've pre-mixed an ounce of all of my colors. I have not added any sort of silicone to them. So this is, again, going to be my first piece here using a strainer. I can't wait to try this. So bear with me, and I hope y'all enjoy it. My white is pre-mixed. So that's why this one's going to come directly out of the bottle versus my little cups like all of my other colors. I just want to get this on here to get some colors going in. In hindsight, I kind of wish my magenta was a little bit brighter than it is, but it's all right. We will try this out and see how it goes. And I am going with a rainbow technique, so I'm going with the Roy G. Biv color scheme. So red or pink, and then orange, yellow, green, and then my blue here. And then my purple. wanted to use some of that white in between my colors here. You just kind of barely see what's going on here under this strainer. So I am pouring on a 12 by 12 stretch canvas here tonight. And I know that I am going to need roughly 6 ounces of paint. So I do have 6 ounces of my colors here. I can see now that my strainer here is kind of blocking some of my colors. This is a strainer I just got tonight, so I'm not really sure how well this would work out here, but I definitely wanted to try this. I was inspired to try this technique from Kat, who shared a video of this technique on my page and asked if I'd ever tried it, and I hadn't, so I wanted to make sure I tried something like this out. So thank you, Pat, for sharing this on my page and inspiring me to try this. And again, none of my colors have any silicone in them tonight. I'm not really worried about getting cells so much as I am about getting a really cool effect. Oh, that's going to look really awesome. I'll try and put this back down where it was here. think this is going to be so awesome when we pull this up here. And I think I'm going to need to grab another canvas just to set my strainer on, because I think that's going to also be really cool, and I don't want to just lose that. Although, I do have my plastic down, so I could make a really cool skin out of that too. I mean, how cool does just that even look in there? I mean, it looks awesome. And I can already tell you that even though I've got no silicone in here, I am already seeing cells underneath this strainer. So this is gonna be very interesting here. Can I just tell y'all, I love this neon purple. Apparently I love it so much I'm using it faster than all my other colors. Alright, let's get this finished out here. I like to use as much of my paints as possible. I mean, why be wasteful? I think next time I'll definitely make this pink that I used tonight. I would definitely go brighter next time, for sure. So I'm hoping that once I lift this strainer, I'm not gonna have to do a whole lot of tilting. But we'll see what happens. Like I said, this is my first attempt at a strainer pour, so we will just see how this goes. I'm so glad that y'all are here watching and learning with me. So in my previous video, I talked about how I mixed my paints, and I actually used these paints in that video. So if you are brand new to this style or this type of art, you might want to check that out and just see how I mix my colors and my paints to get them to be able to pour like this. Apparently I really, really liked this blue and purple. I used way more of them than I did all the other colors. So I only have a tiny, tiny little bit left of each of these. So I wanted try and literally get every drop that I can. This purple though, y'all. Oh my gosh, I'm in love. It's like electric purple. There is such a thing. Another canvas that I've got prepped here. Pick up another canvas I've got prepped here, and I'm going to set my strainer on that canvas. Boy, look at that, y'all. How cool does that look? Oh my gosh, that's awesome. Look at all these cells that I'm getting. I wasn't really going for cells tonight, since I had this strainer pour, but hey, I got them anyway. So let's see what we can do with this. Let's put some white around here. Now we can kind of tilt this puppy around. See what we can do. To this corner here. Don't really want too much of it flowing off. Stretch this back towards the center here as much as I can. I'm gonna go towards that opposite corner there. I'll let some of that flow off, but not a whole lot here. I want to bring my paint back towards the center. Let it flow off this way here. This paint is really thick on here, y'all. And again, I want to bring that back towards the center because I really kind of like that design. This edge here. And again, I don't want a whole lot of this flowing off. Because I really kind of like what's going on there. How cool is that? Looking. Just looks so neat. Can't begin to tell you how many times I have put my shirt in my painting, y'all. It happens a lot. So I've got a dedicated paint shirt. And what we'll do is we'll just come back here. On this edge with the white. I like this bit of white right here as well. And I think what I'm going to do is on these edges here, I'm going to kind of blow this out and see what we can get here. Oh, look at that fun color that we got right there. And I've just put my arm in the painting because, shocker there, I do something to it every time. Although I guess that was kind of meant to be because that's really cool right there. And the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my trusty little torch here. And I'm going to torch this. Maybe lower that flame though. And again, I'm not trying to dry my paint, toast it, anything like that. I am just literally wanting to pop some air bubbles. Awesome. Well, folks, I am going to probably play with this one just a little bit more. I really like these little like tendrils that kind of came out, so I want to try and pull this purple out a little bit more. So this is just a wooden dowel. I got like a pack of 10 or 20, 15 wooden dowels from the Dollar Tree, and I used a pencil sharpener to just kind of point down one end, not super pointy, but just to kind of give me something thicker than a toothpick to kind of pull my paints around with here. I kind of pull those in a little bit. Actually, oh yeah, it's alright. Because it just kind of wanted it to do that. Now it looks like my piece did get kind of muddy, especially right here, and I think what happened is the bottom of my strainer has these feet that really, I think, kind of created a suction on my canvas where my paint couldn't really go anywhere. So I think it just kind of sat there and puddled up and got kind of muddy. But that's okay. This still turned out really pretty cool, so I'm excited. And then now I can take my smaller toothpick and really kind of have fun with some of these smaller designs here. The great thing about this is you could literally just sit here and continue to play with it and make it your own. Like I said, my colors did really kind of muddy up a little bit, but then I've got some really great pieces like this that just pop through and shine through. And then I actually really kind of love how this looks right here. Really like this as well. And I can, once this dries, I can always kind of go back with my pink right around here and add some of that in there as well. So right now I'm just kind of looking for some really fun areas to just add some whimsy here. Overall, I think this was a really fun pour. I am excited to try another strainer some other time and see what I can do with that. But I think that this was really, really cool. I'll be trying some other techniques. I think the next time I try a strainer, I might try a layered dirty pour cup. So I'm just pouring it in there, the one, all at once. But I think that will be really, really fun, and I hope that y'all tune in for that. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments below, and if you've got questions on how I did this, what colors I used, what techniques I used, anything like that, please, please let me know, and I will definitely get back with you on that. I love answering those questions. So, again, thank you so much for watching. If you are not subscribed already, I would really love a subscribe. A thumbs up as well if you liked this as well. And then again, comments are great. I really, really appreciate it. And just again, thank you so much for watching.